Hello everyone. Today in this module you will be learning about how to prepare double column cash book. Let's get started. This is the format of double column cash book. On the debit side there will be total of 6 columns. Date, second column will be there for particulars, or you can also write down receipts. Third column will be for voucher number, then ledger folio, cash, and next column will be for the bank. And same columns will be there on the credit side. The only difference, instead of writing down particulars, you can also write down payments. Now, come to the first point. Suppose you are given some opening cash and bank balance, then you will write it on the receipt side to balance brought down. This concept already we have discussed while preparing single column cash book. So opening cash balance will be written over here and opening bank balance will be written over here. Now regarding bank balance, there may be credit balance, which you better know as the bank overdraft. So in case instead of debit balance you are given credit balance of bank, then you will write here by balance brought down and amount will be written in the bank column. Now let us come to the second point. Now suppose on 3rd April you have sold some goods and out of the sale proceeds some amount you have received in cash and some amount you have received by way of check, and check was deposited by you on the same day. Then whatever amount you have received in form of cash, that you will write down in the cash column, and the amount that you have received by way of check, that you will write down in the bank column. Next one is here. I have written over here to Mohan. That means you have received some amount from Mohan. Amount received in cash will be written over here. Same way, if you have received in check, that you will write down in the bank column. Next can be like you have received some commission. Commission, if you have received in cash, then you will write down in cash column. If you have received in the form of check, then you will write down in the bank column. Next one. If you have deposited cash into bank, then it will affect cash column as well as bank column. Just imagine, when you deposit cash into bank, then your bank balance will increase. That means bank will be debited. So here you will debit the amount in the bank column, and in particulars from where this amount is deposited into the bank, it will be written to cash account. And on the credit side, you will write down the same amount in the cash column. Why? Because when you deposit cash into bank, if bank balance will increase, then the cash balance will decrease. So you will write down the same amount in the cash column, and in particulars you will write down by bank account. And one thing that you have to keep in mind, in ledger folio column you will write down C represents contra entries. This concept of contra entries already we have discussed in the classroom. Next is a transaction. If you withdraw cash from bank, then what will happen? If you withdraw cash from bank, bank balance will decrease. So you will write down this amount on the credit side in the bank column, and cash balance will increase. So same amount you will write down in the cash column, and in ledger folio you will write down C. Similarly, if you have received bank has allowed some interest on your balance, then that will be added in your bank balance automatically by the bank. So here you will write down, it is your income, so you will write down to interest account, and the amount will be written in the bank column. On the credit side, here I have written some items. We can go through these items one by one. Like first item I have written by purchases account. If you have made payment in cash, you will write down in the cash column. And if you have made payment through check, you will write down in the bank column. By Sohan, that means you have made some amount due to Sohan. Rule will be the same. If the payment is made in cash, you will write down in the cash column. And if the payment is made by check, then you will write down in the bank column. Similarly, for the next item, by salaries. Next two items already we have discussed. Next, like you have received a check from Mohan and you have deposited this check into the bank, but later on this check gets dishonored, then what will you do? What entry will you pass? Simply you will write down, you will debit the amount in Mohan account and credit the bank account by the same amount. So your entry will be Mohan debit to bank account. That means your bank balance will decrease by the amount of the dishonored check. So you will write down here. Bank may charge some amount from you for providing you the services. That we better know as the bank charges. So that bank will debit in your account. So you will write down by bank charges here. You will show this amount in the bank column because your bank balance will decrease by the amount charged by the bank as bank charges. After posting all the transactions, at the end of the month, we will total both the cash columns and the bank columns on the debit side as well as on the credit side. Debit side, you will write down total receipts, and credit, you will write down total payments. And by comparing both, you will find out the balancing figure. If the debit side is more, you will write down by balance carried down. In cash column, always debit will be more than the credit. Because we know the rule, because you can't spend more than what you are having as cash balance. But in case of bank, credit may be more than the debit. That means it represents your negative balance. It represents the bank overdraft. So you will write down on the debit side to balance carried down. Let us take an example for the same to have a better understanding of this concept. Now let us discuss a practical example to better understand the preparation of cash book. Let's take the example of a new business. Started business with cash rupees 1,20,000. So after preparing your format, here you will write down the name of the proprietor or the name of the company. Then you will write down the title, which book you are preparing, cash book. On the left hand side you will write down debit, and on the right hand side you will write down credit. And then you will write down the name of these columns. And already I have told you, instead of writing down particulars, you can also write down receipts, and here you can write down payments. So the first transaction, started business with cash rupees 1,20,000. So its entry will be cash account debit to capital account. That means cash balance will increase. So you will write down on the debit side, amount will be shown in the cash column, and here you will write down to capital account. Cash paid into bank. What is the entry for this transaction? It is bank account debit to cash account. So it is affecting both cash account as well as bank account. Bank balance is increasing and the cash balance is decreasing. So here bank balance is increasing, so you will write down on the debit side and amount will be shown in the bank column, and here you will write down to cash account. But at the same time cash balance is decreasing, so you will write down on the credit side, and amount you will write down in the here you will write down by bank account. Don't forget to write C in the ledger folio on both sides. C denotes contra entries. That means the entry that appear on both sides of cash book. If one account is balance in one account is increasing, then the balance in other account is decreasing. Purchase goods from Sushmita. Now my question is whether this transaction is a cash transaction or the credit transaction. Right, this is a credit transaction, so you will not show this transaction in the cash book. Sold goods to Dinkar and received a check ₹20,000. And here you are depositing this check in the bank on which date? On 14th April. So here what will be your entry? Yes, check in hand account debit to sales account. But again, this entry will be shown in journal proper, not in the cash book. Paid to Sushmita cash. You are making payment, so you will show on the payment side by Sushmita. And how you are making her the payment? In cash. So you will write down the amount in cash column. Next, check received on April 6, 2019 deposited into bank. So its entry will be bank account debit to check in hand. So bank balance will increase, and here you will write down to check in hand. Sold goods to Rani. Again, this is a cash or credit transaction? Yes, this is a credit transaction, so it will not be shown in the cash book. Next, Cartes paid in cash. Payment, so you will write down on the payment side by Cartes. And as you are making payment in cash, so you will write down the amount in the cash column. Here, maximum transactions that I have taken, I have shown the cash transactions. In the next example, we will discuss about, in the next module actually, we will discuss some more questions where we will take examples of banking transactions. Received cash from Rani. You are receiving cash, so here you will write down to Rani, and amount you will write down in the cash column. Same way, commission received to commission account, here you will write down 5,000. Drew cash for personal use. You are drawing cash from the business, so cash balance with the business will decrease. So here you will write down by drawings account, and 2,000 you will write down in the cash column. Now we have arrived at the end of the question. So in the last, what will you do? You will total both cash column as well as bank column on the debit side as well as on the credit side. Total of cash column, here it will be 1,37,000. Total of bank column will be 70,000. And here total payments, these are shown over here. Then in the last, like other accounts, we are required to balance cash book also. Total receipts 1,37,000, total payment 72,500. So we are left with the balance of 64,500 in the cash account. Similarly, in the bank column, debit side total 70,000 and nil balance on the credit side. So you will be having a balance of 70,000 in your bank account. This is how you can prepare your cash book. And don't forget to write down over here date. Balance you are calculating on which date? At the end of the month. So here what you will write down? You will write down the April 30. So this is how you can prepare your cash book. So this is all for the day. Next we will discuss some more examples, so you will be better able to understand how to prepare your cash book. Now what you are required to do? You need to practice some simple questions to have a better idea of preparation of your cash book. Thank you.